the goal this year was really to stabilize the first year enrollment and see if we could increase it by 3%, which would have been a first year class of about 1,300 students. And we came in within eight students of that. So I'm feeling actually pretty good. The overall enrollment did drop by a percentage, and we anticipated that because of the large graduating class we had last spring. So, you know, what we're doing is really trying to focus on one class at a time to stabilize the enrollment and ultimately increase it. So next year the goals will be higher, but we're not ready to set them yet until I have some more analysis.
Sure. Now let's talk about some of the strategies. I know that when we first met you, you had some really innovative ideas on especially getting high school kids interested and basically financially committed to the University of Montana. How has that gone?
Yeah, so the Raise Me Scholarship Program, it was a new program that we implemented last summer where students beginning in ninth grade can start to enter their grades into the program, and then they get small scholarships for good grades. So $20 for an A or, you know, $15 for community service, that sort of thing. And that money accumulates over 4 years and can be only used at the University of Montana. And as of earlier this week, we had 16,000 students sign up for the program. And we noted that we had a higher number of in-state students, which we believe is directly related to the Raise Me program. So we think it's working really well.
All right. Now, what about, are there any strategies for trying to get more international students?
Yeah, that's a great question. So international recruiting was moved to our office just in this past spring. And so what we will be doing is be hiring an international recruiter this year because we're in the recruiting season right now. I'm working with faculty who are traveling overseas to do recruiting for us. And then in addition to that, we recruit at international high schools within the United States. So that's something that we're going to be focusing on as well. That's an area that really, really could really increase our enrollment, and we just haven't taken advantage of it before, so I'm thrilled to have that area.
Are there any is there any financial help specifically for international students?
Well, we do have a scholarship now where if you're not a state student, because tuition is about $24,000, tuition and fees, where if you have a 2.75 cumulative GPA and a 22 ACT, you would receive an automatic $5,000 merit-based scholarship. So that would apply to not only out-of-state students, but also international students as well.
All right. As we move forward, I know that you're not the kind of man not to have a long-term plan. So
right.
what's your long-term plan?
Well, the long-term plan is to, you know, get into a position where we can realistically grow the enrollment back to, you know, nearly where it was before. That's going to take some time. In the admission office, we have to really focus on strategies that, one, increase the number of staff members to help work on that, help us do the recruiting. Right now, I only have four recruiters. At my former job of an institution of 2,100 students, I had 17 recruiters. So you can see the big difference there. The more that we recruit in-state and out-of-state in particular, the more recruiters you need. So we're slowly getting that support with this positive uptick in the incoming class. And then I think that with a new president coming, there will be a greater emphasis focused on enrollment. President Stearns has been really terrific in terms of allowing me to, you know, spend the resources that I need to get the job done.